What's going on, guys? Corey here. Just after doing the vacuuming on this little job here. We're out in Spicewood. That's where Willie Nelson lives, out here, somewhere, Spicewood. I'm getting ready to do two rooms and a little section of hall. The little hallway is the only place that's really showing any real actual need. Bedroom over here to my left needs me a little bit. The one over there in front of me needs me a little bit too. This job, I'm three flights up. The only carpet is basically up here. So I've elected to bring up the Oryx and leave the Challenger on the van because it's not gonna take a whole lot to get this clean. And I was thinking about this, you know, before I started the video. There was a time in my life, you know, right at about 20 years ago when I first began and I was cleaning with steam, I would have drug the hoses up here. I would have brought the Oryx 20. I would have ran everything on high. I would have got the heat as high as I could possibly get it. I would have soaked it with Enzol and ran it like I was trying to clean a dirty restaurant, simply because there was nobody to tell me any different. You know, the guys at the carpet shop wouldn't tell you, no, you don't need to use all of that, you know, because the more you use, the more they sell. So there was nobody to advise me otherwise. You know, so a lot of times people think that they need to go all out in order to get a carpet clean, and you don't. So basically, I've scaled this one down to the bare minimum. It'll take me a little longer with the Oryx to get it clean, but it proves my point that, you know, it's basically knowledge and understanding carpet, and honestly, getting it dry quickly is a huge benefit to you. You know, had this been 20 years ago and I ran the Oryx 20 over it, you know, and cycled that much water through it, you know, who knows what could have happened, you know, in the long dry time that it would have had. But let's take a look here, and we'll talk about it a little bit before I begin. This one, I'll probably show some cleaning with the Oryx, as boring as it is. All right, now that section of hall there is pretty much as bad as it's gonna get here. In here, there's a little bit of stuff going on in here, kind of right in the doorway a little bit. Some of what you're seeing is shadows casted from me, but over in this area, you can tell it needs some attention. I'm not understanding exactly how to turn the light on. So I'm using these two guys here, those two little guys there, and I don't know exactly how to make that thing on the wall work right. And in this other bedroom in here, I am going to clean. I'm not moving the rug. So basically, I'm going to clean this section here and then over here. And it's got a little bit going on. And there's one bedroom that I'm going to skip altogether, which is over here. Now, I will, before I begin, while there's still light out, I'll take you downstairs so you can see exactly. See, we're out on the lake here. I don't know if we can see through the over there. Basically, you can see the water. It's tough to see through the screen with a camera, but we're out in Spicewood, and that is, I believe that's still Lake Travis. It's not one of the Highland lakes that's farther up. Anyway, like I said, we're on the third floor, so this is why I opted to bring this guy up here. So I brought this guy up, and I brought the sprayer, basically. So that's all you need to get this clean, you know. And if it was god awful terrible, I'd bring the Challenger up and just muscle it up the stairs. So here's my idea. This is what it takes to get carpet clean and keep people happy. As long as it looks good when you're done and stays looking good and doesn't wick back, everybody's really, really happy. All right, so this is exactly why I opted to not bring the Challenger up. There I am parked right there. So why would I carry heavy equipment all the way up here to get to the third floor? This is why I say if you're gonna start a small carpet cleaning business, you need a Challenger and an Oryx. And like I always say, definitely buy your Oryx used and buy two of them because they're gonna break. They're made of junk. They say heavy duty because that's just what they wrote on them. They're not heavy duty. right. Now, I'm going to pre-spray everything we just talked about, and then I will set up the camera here to watch some cleaning going on, and especially in the hall here. That's the only thing really worth watching. So anyway, I'll be back. All right, guys, getting ready to start cleaning here. I've got the fork up close here, and I'm gonna try to be watching to make sure I don't have that same issue I had yesterday where it keeps trying to zoom in on me. So here we go. Maybe I'm gonna show this whole job since it's so small. It looks like it is doing okie dokie so far here. Doesn't look like it's zooming in. You see me putting some footprints in it for sure. Point this guy a little more at the ground here. We may just do this whole job here in real time. Might not even have to cut the video. Except for when I turn the camera around. Who knows? We'll see. There was something out there, I didn't know what it was, and I pre-soaked it a little bit with ammonia, and I'm glad I did, because it was a little difficult to make come out, so if it weren't for the ammonia, it might not have come out as good as it did. Hit it again with this ammonia, and then run back over it again a couple times. Some fun calling around all the carbon supply places and asking if they stock ammonia. I mean, they're not going to stock ammonia because they wouldn't need to stock anything else if they stocked ammonia. And there's this guy on YouTube and he swears by ammonia. They'd hate that, I promise. All right, shorten this guy up a little bit. Stay with me. All right, now right here, it was basically over there was where any issue was at. And it basically went away when I pre-sprayed it. We're going to get it the rest of the way now. Now, talk about simplicity in cleaning carpet, huh, guys? This is, I believe, as simple as you can possibly make it, which is something that's hard for a big company to sell you because they're not selling simple, they're selling expensive and complex, and carpet is simple. Times I feel like when you know, some of the younger guys that don't have any experience, you know, when they find this channel and they just went out and purchased a, you know, a van and a truck mount, and then they see me talking about how simple carpet cleaning is and what I'm doing it with and how long I've been doing it, it really just generally pisses them off because they went out and they made all that purchase, and nobody likes to feel like they've been lied to or admit that maybe they're wrong. That's a hard thing to do. I did it, you know, but luckily I'd already had my truck mount for about 6 years. And once I found VLM cleaning, I never went back. But it took a guy with a Butler system to prove me wrong about, you know, steam cleaning being the only way to do things. been cleaning for 11 minutes so far here. Open that door back up. We're gonna clean this area here next. And it looks like that'll probably be the best way to do things. My watch, it seems like, there we go. Now it's back. It doesn't look like it's zoomed in either. It's still working. At least the way I want it to. This area here, I think this is probably going to be the first job that I've ever shown the entire cleaning, just because of the size of it here. You know, for a while now, I've been planning on raising my prices for 2020, but kind of the way things are going now, since I became a Challenger dealer and that's going really well, and for some reason I've ran into a bunch of really, really good subscribers that are very grateful. They will send gifts, you know, money and stuff like that. And so what I've decided to do is not raise my prices after all. I'm almost monetized with my channel. So I feel like actually in a year or so, I may actually drop my prices the better I do on YouTube. That way I can help more people and, you know, feel better about it, if that makes any sense. I told you my channel was different than anybody else's, and I was serious when I said that. This is not all about the money. This is about how you treat people. And that's when you're running a home service business or a cleaning business, it is 100% about how you treat people. The job you do matters a lot, but how you treat people means more than absolutely anything that I could ever describe to you. But the way you treat your client means more than the way that you clean. Considerably more. There's the old saying that if you start a business purely to make money, you probably won't. And you can pretty much live by that. Let's take us a quick look around here. Let me shorten up my tripod some here. Like I said, until we get a cameraman, you're gonna be dealing with not the best camera work here at all. Looks like we're about 18 minutes into the cleaning now and I'm done. A few more things we'll talk about here. But basically, what I'm gonna do now is I'm not gonna make a special trip down for the groomer. What I'm gonna do is we're gonna show all this and I'm gonna run the work over my footprints and knock them out of here. And then basically exit stage left going down the stairs and be done with it. All in here is the only areas that really need to knock my footprints back out of it. You're looking at about an hour's dry time, maybe less. I did add alcohol to this, so that'll generally speed up the drying, and I'm gonna turn that fan on. I don't know how to turn the light on, but I didn't know how to turn the fan on, so we're gonna do that. All right, guys, hang on just a second. All right, guys, all finished here, except for what I talked about. I'm gonna run the work over the deal. I really know, for some reason, you know, I'm only 3 years into it, and I'm definitely not a, you know, an actor or anything, so when you look at the camera, you look at yourself, it somehow, it kind of erases the memory about what you were gonna say, and it'll go away in time and I'll get better at doing this, conveying my point to you guys. But basically, like I was saying, it's not about your equipment, it's about the way you treat your client. It's not about steam, it's not about VLM. If you give a damn about your job, you'll do a good job, and you'll have open communication between your clients. I prefer to work directly for the client. I won't work through like Home Advisor or any of that crap. They're driving up the cost of home services, something terrible. I won't work for somebody that wants to contract me to do like carpet stretching or carpet repair and have them be the contact and me come in and do the job. I will be the one that speaks with the clientele so they know exactly what to expect, because if you don't know anything about setting up a carpet stretching or carpet repair job over the phone, you're not going to be the one to talk to the client for me. I've told a guy to just not contact me anymore that was trying to do that, because you can make a bunch of promises that can't be kept if you don't understand anything about carpet stretching or carpet repair. kind of on a different note there and all. But anyway, we're almost at Christmas now. I'm leaving town Friday afternoon or Saturday morning. I'm not exactly sure which. I had to check with the wife. She's the one that knows all that stuff. Anyway, this next year, if you're interested in purchasing a Challenger OP with me, you get a $100 rebate that I mail to you out of my commission as my way of saying thank you. And then you get basically a lifetime of text support on how to use your new equipment. You know, there's certain guys that are just getting into the business that, you know, there's questions they're going to have and there's simple answers to all of them. There's guys that have contacted me and bought machines that are switching from Steam over to VLM. And it's a different mindset on how to do the cleaning. And it's very simple. You have to think a lot more simply than what you're doing when you're trying to cycle water through the carpet with a hot water extraction. Altogether different. So, you know, if you decide to purchase a machine through me, I've got your back from that point on. What I'm doing now is I went around and everybody that's bought, you know, a machine from me this year, everybody that's reached out to me in a manner that I found very respectful. Some of the guys that have sent basically thank you money and gifts and stuff like that. I'm collecting their addresses and I'm sending out Christmas cards to these guys because I'm going to run my YouTube channel the exact same way I run my business, with care and respect. The biggest thing that I'm gonna have problems with is in the future as this thing grows, is that, you know, I've stated that I'm here to help everybody. I've got to find some way to be okay with having these guys send me money and have me not feel bad. You know, it's when someone feels grateful and they want to do something for you, you need to let them. You don't need to take that away from them. You know, the feeling that I get for sharing information with someone that saves them thousands of dollars a year on their cleaning chemical and the way they clean and all of that, that feels good. So some people want to reciprocate that, and I've got to try to find a way to make that okay. It's felt funny in the past, but I am very grateful for you guys that have taken the time out. It's not really the money that you've sent that feels good. It's the fact that you reached out to me to say thank you, and you took the time to prove that you really do appreciate what I'm doing. Appreciation goes a really, really long way with me. I could yammer on, but I've got an hour's drive back to the house, and I got to upload these videos the rest of the night. So guys, as always, if you have questions, the number is 512-350-1129. Please feel free to text. It's always better to text than to call, because a lot of times I don't answer the phone when you call, because it's always somebody trying to sell me insurance or a website or some kind of something that I don't need. Thanks for watching, guys. God bless, and I will see you again tomorrow.